I'm Shane.
And if you like what you hear, make sure you hit that thumbs up button real hard and make sure you subscribe to Comic Movie Marks.
And also click that little bell for all of the notifications.
Whee!
Always remember,
if trailer trash can do it,
anyone can do it.
Woo! Hello and welcome everyone to another Comic Movie Marks video. We're fucked.
Yeah, pretty much. We were duped. We had a completely different plan for this episode, but we said, fuck it, we're going to wing it. Our original plan was to talk about a comicbookmovie.com article, a very elaborate one written by Josh Wilding, and he pretty much duped us.
Yep. Pretty much.
the title of the article was Joss Whedon finally breaks his silence on Justice League. Not every superhero movie can be the Avengers, quote. And Matt and I were like, holy shit, how did this not circulate, you know, through social media? This is the first time we're hearing about it. And we figured out why. When you look at the date, it was actually written 16 days ago as of this recording. So on April 1st. Was, if that wasn't clue enough, then we start reading through some of the comments, some of the angering comments, and some of them start saying, oh, I hate April Fool's Day with this website, and blah, 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 and we're like, oh, well, fuck. So,
and man, did they go through some shit to write that fake article. It was interesting. It actually had a very funny moment where I was thinking, like, oh, man, Joss is actually kind of funny on that one remark. But about the reason why Superman's face was so fucked up during the movie is because he got beat up by Doomsday.
Right.
After effect of Doomsday. And I actually was like, that's pretty fucking funny. Too bad none of his other jokes are funny. But it turns out it wasn't him. And that's why it was funny.
Yeah, it definitely, it now makes sense because when you're reading it, you're like, man, he's just trolling the shit out of these people. Even like one of the last lines or the last sentences, but it is almost one of the last sentences in the article says he then walked off stage in his scruffy Avengers shirt, giggling to himself about something we'll probably never actually know the full story about. And I'm like, man, this fucking douche is just trolling the shit out of these people with all these comments and kind of like making backhanded comments and everything like that. And and almost like to me, and my whole argument was going to be, oh, Joss is just, he's not taking any accountability for this movie. And then, you know, you find out it's fake, like, oh, okay, I've been duped.
April Fool's, 2 weeks later, still fucking us over.
Yeah, exactly. So fuck this Josh Wilding guy. And as Matt said before we started recording, it's no wonder we only have 500 subscribers.
Because we don't know what the fuck we're doing.
Yeah, so now, congratulations. You guys will hear us just try to wing it through an episode just so we can get some content up for those 500 followers. Or, I'm sorry, subscribers. So thank you.
Yeah, come on. They had to click a whole button to get to see us or listen to us.
Right.
So we're just going to wing some DC news that's just been floating around for the last week or so. Nothing really too extravagant. Nothing too amazing in general. Something's funny. Something's sad. Some things that make no fucking sense, kind of like the DC universe.
Ooh, shots fired.
Well, no, I mean, by the end of Justice League, it just made no sense. You know, yeah. It was sad. Now it doesn't make sense. So we'll just talk about something that I actually thought was interesting here, and that's James Wan, the director of Aquaman, the last standing DC movie of the year. But anyway, so James Wan actually came out, and he's been refuting some of these arguments and articles that are going on about Aquaman. And it's actually kind of interesting because I've always thought that some of these directors should do this. Like, don't let the bullshit circulate like this. But this actually proves, in James Wan's matter, where he's come out and keeps refuting things, people keep turning it on over and over again. And now, apparently, even when you respond and try to clarify things, you're just feeding the beast.
Yeah, basically. It's pretty sad and... It's awesome that James Wan is actually coming out, like you said, and trying to, you know, give a refute some of this crap that's coming out. The hack journalists, as some people on social media say, they just keep fucking pumping it out. Like, they do not want to hear it at all. So basically, one of the hack journalists, she puts, I'm not even sure what she is from. She has the little blue check mark, but her name is Grace Randolph. And she says, so wow, last week, #Aquaman managed to announce pickups. and adding Park Randall as a brand new character without anyone noticing. And it actually looks like she does a video on it. Then James Wan actually replies and he says, "Hiya, Grace, love your stuff, so I'll speak up. I didn't add a new character now. Dr. Shin was in the script since day one. I had cast Randall a year ago in Aust?
August. It's Twitter, so they're shortening shit up. Supposed to be
August. Okay. So in August. And then in parentheses, he says, I'm a big fan of his love FOTB. I'm not quite sure what that is. But then he said, but I didn't shoot his stuff until now. Hence, it's literally pickups with him. Cheers.
I'm actually wondering if Aust is August or not. I don't know, actually.
Yeah, I'm like, Australia? I totally fucking confused.
Whatever. Some fucking kid out there will correct us. And they'll let us know what FOTB is as well.
Yeah, probably.
Fuck off the boat. Fuck off the boat.
FOTB. No idea.
Oh, okay. I thought you were typing it in. Anyway, so, you know, James Wan, he goes in there. He tries to clarify this Grace Rudolph is... Randolph, I'm sorry. Rudolph, the red-nosed reindeer. Randolph, she kind of makes this abrupt message out there. Like, no one noticed this? And he points it out. Like, no, you're not understanding. What I'm saying is... that, or what happened is, he was already part of the set he was already part of the cast a long time ago. We just doing pickups with him now and adjusting some things. Nothing is going on here. It's just regular pickups. Well, then Screen Rant comes out and
like a bunch pretty of much dicks.
just like how Shane comes in there, bunch of dicks. James Wan or Screen Rant puts James Wan announced Aquaman reshoots, but made it seem like a good thing. So again, his words are getting twisted again, and it just doesn't seem like he can win. And then he has to respond to them now. I've directed 9 features over the course of my career thus far, and only one of those, Death Sentence, didn't have additional photography. I'm assuming that's what that means. It says photog. So photography / reshoots. On Saw, I dumped buckets of blood on at L. Walner. I don't know. His head.
Al Wanell's head? Something like that?
His head. Poured blood on his head. On Conjuring 2, I added a demon nun. On Furious 7, I had Dwayne drive an ambulance. Well, that's one hell of a reshoot. Anyway. And he has to clarify this again. So we'll see who the next article is. Maybe fucking Screen Rant will come back, or it'll be some other CBR or somebody will be like, James Wan says Dwayne The Rock Johnson is going to be in an ambulance and Aquaman. You know, fuck it. It's probably going to twist it around again.
Yeah, right. Yeah, fucking probably. So actually, I did look up FOTB just for shits and giggles, and it actually is... the acronym for the sitcom Fresh Off the Boat, which Randall Park is a part of. And I actually knew that, so I don't know why I did not piece that together.
Dude, but I got 3 of those right. I said, fuck off the boat.
Yeah, you did. Wow.
I was so close and not even knowing how. So James Wan will continue to fight with these idiots on social media. It kind of makes you wonder, like, if you should bother. Maybe, I mean, Matt Reeves, he tries every once in a while, and then his shit gets misconstrued. I mean, even after he's clarified several times that the Batman will be part of the DC Universe, I keep seeing articles over and over again that maybe this Batman actually won't be part of the DC Universe. And I think he's just given up on that shit. And then now, with speaking of Batman, Jake Gyllenhaal, this is a little old, but I just thought this was funny. He was directly answered, like, are you going to play Batman? He's like, that's a tough question. No.
So, I guess I can think of one role that encompasses all of that.
Okay.
Is Jake Gyllenhaal going to be the next Batman?
Wow, that's a very difficult question. The answer to that question is no.
I've seen some people say, like, well, it's not like he's actually going to answer her. But why would he give such a jackass answer? Right. I don't know. It just seems like to me he's just like more shocked that this shit is even continuing. Same thing with Joaquin Phoenix. Everybody's saying he's playing coy right now because he doesn't know what the hell they're talking about when it comes to the Joker movie.
addressed the rumors with a big smile, saying, "I don't even know what this movie is." He added, "What is everyone talking about?" However, he did say that he thinks Heath Ledger's performance as the Joker in Christopher Nolan's The Dark Knight is fucking brilliant. But he's never really been a huge fan of the Batman comic series.
And that's what they're referencing, that, oh, he's playing coy. I'm like, yeah, because you guys have such a great track record of nailing who's playing in these movies.
Oh, absolutely. Fucking Armie Hammer, does that ring a bell? Everyone was saying that. And I bought into that. I absolutely was like, oh, he might just be fucking with us. And then the more things started coming out where he's like, no, I was calling my agent saying, are you sure that WB hasn't called yet? You know, like... then you start to realize, fuck, that actually isn't happening. And, you know, people, it amazes me, the shit that comes out. And that's why now half the shit we're even talking about, I'm like, it's, who knows if it's real or not.
And speaking of shit that's probably not even real, we got a Birds of Prey director. Cool.
Yeah, apparently so. Kathy Yan is supposed to direct Birds of Prey, and Suicide Squad 2 is like not being shot now or something. Fuck, no idea.
So we have a director for that. We have a lot of directors for these DC movies.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, well, we got I always forget his name, but the gentleman that's doing Nightwing. I mean, he's still floating around. You got Matt Reeves. He's still floating around. You got apparently Todd Phillips and Martin Scorsese, a producer and director writer there on for that Joker movie. Then you have the woman that just got put towards that just started taking over for New Gods. I forget her name as well. But it's like we got all these ideas, all this shit going on, but no movies.
Yeah, again, it's hard to figure out what's actually real. I'm just waiting for official stuff to start to be released. And us to have like a slate or something that they can go off of. I know we've had it before, and that's pretty much trash, you know, tear it all up, forget any of the logos or anything that we saw. But I'm just waiting for more shit to actually come out and go, okay, now we're starting to produce this. Until I start seeing some behind the scenes shit, like leaked set footage, I'm not going to believe it.
That's what I mean. You just got to wait till they start filming this shit. And then we have Warner Brothers Pictures Group Chairman Toby Emmerich made the announcement today that Steven Spielberg will produce his first DC title for Warner Brothers, Blackhawk, with an eye on the three-time Oscar-winning filmmaker director under his own, Amblin banner. I don't know, whatever his company name is. Again, you have like these major names like Martin Scorsese. Now you have Steven Spielberg. I mean, you have all these names tied to like producing some of this DC content, but yet you don't have a slate. You don't have any idea. Like all these ideas are being thrown out there. And I'm wondering how many of these things could be animated. How many of these things are possibly for the DC network? I'm starting to wonder maybe if they're going to produce some small short films. Not necessarily short films, but some small films with these type of obscure characters. And they're going to be using it for the DC streaming service. Are they going to be like DC exclusive streaming service things? Just like Netflix original or something like that.
Yeah, exactly. As soon as you said, that never even crossed my mind until you brought it up before we started recording. And the more I started thinking about it, I'm like, fuck, like they would have to pump out a ton of money, you know, and hope that they gain it back through the streaming service. But as you just pointed out, Netflix has done that. You know, they signed a huge deal with Adam Sandler. Not that any of those movies are really all that good. But they have a lot of Netflix original series that actually are bringing a lot of eyeballs to Netflix specifically. So, that's definitely a possibility that they might go with lesser known, you know, Birds of Prey, Blackhawk, lesser known type things, maybe even Suicide Squad 2 down the road or Batgirl, something like that, and just say, hey, let's just do this a little bit lower budget film, as they should, and just put it out on the streaming service, on their network or whatever the fuck you want to call it. So that's definitely a possibility. It'll be interesting to see how that whole thing unfolds.
That's the only thing I can think of, because it just doesn't make sense to me at this point that they have all these directors assigned to all these projects, and they're going to be putting in a bunch of money to these projects, writing. Obviously, they got to pay Spielberg no matter what. They got to pay Martin Scorsese no matter what. I mean, these are big names to have tied up producing your content. So it seems like to me there is a quick action plan to turn this stuff around into something different, either a type of DC streaming service exclusive, maybe an animated movie. I just don't see these going theatrical. Maybe the Birds of Prey one, just because it has Harley Quinn in it and Margot Robbie, mm-hmm. and that's a big enough name to carry in theaters.
Yeah.
To produce in a theatrical version. But these other Blackhawk, like, really? Like, that's just Jesus Christ. I barely know what that is. And I just know that's like from like a Wonder Woman fucking animated movie I think I've seen.
Right.
Like, that, I think that's it. Like, that's like, unless you're going to make it like Dunkirk, but Blackhawk, like DC Universe or something. I don't fucking know exactly how you would pull it off, but it seems like to me that would be more an obscure series that could be tied to like your streaming service. Same thing. I would even almost say maybe the New Gods too, because New Gods allows so much work that I think you could actually really, you could almost make it a fucking TV show. Like the Titans, like they're doing the Titans series and shit. Like maybe that'd be better. Make it like a DC streaming service TV show. I mean, it's obviously going to be a movie because she's been assigned as a director for the movie, but I don't know. It's just hard to believe that a lot of these are going to be turned into theatrical versions, especially when you got the fucking main characters that you should be focusing on, like Cyborg, right. Flash. I mean, they kind of moving forward a little bit more on Flash. But you have all these other characters, Batman movie, Man of Steel 2.
Green Lantern, yeah.
Thank you, Green Lantern. I mean, there's to kind of ignore some of those and to make Blackhawk?
Right.
Birds of Prey?
That's exactly where my head's at. Of like, what are they, if they are moving forward with this, what is their ultimate plan? Do they have a plan? I would assume so now. It's all
part of the plan.
After the atrocious Justice League and what a catastrophe that thing was, they have to be formulating some sort of plan of, okay, here's how we want to move forward. And yeah, I completely agree. And that's exactly where my head has been out of like, what are they doing? What are they going to piece together? And the streaming service, I think, makes the most sense for those. It could be. They might release those as films and then kind of branch off characters from there, but I don't know how you do that with Blackhawk. It doesn't make sense. And they had like Gotham City Sirens, and that was supposed to kind of catapult, you know, some different characters and stuff like that. So it's just weird. It's hard to follow why they would do these more obscure characters when, as you said, where's our Man of Steel 2, Green Lantern, Flash. You know, and the second Wonder Woman, which obviously that one's supposed to be coming out as well. Patty Jenkins is working on that. But like, where are the rest of these? Are we going to get another Justice League movie? Are we going to start branching off of that? You know, even fucking Joss Whedon's version had some foundation laid of like, oh yeah, you know, I picture a circle in the middle of this or whatever, a table, round table in the middle of this fucking, you know, beat to shit manor or whatever. You know, and then Wonder Woman says, "And room for more." So they've laid some foundation, but it's like, what are they doing? Where are they going to go with this? So it's, I don't know.
Yeah, that's actually another one. That's another one. Is there supposed to be a Deathstroke movie too? Remember that? That's rumored as well.
Yeah.
And like I said earlier, there's a Nightwing too. It's like where are these going? Like, are these just made up by bad sources and bad insiders, bad intelligence?
That's a possibility too.
On these, but we have directors assigned to these. That's what makes these a little bit more legitimate, is you have official announcements in some manner. You even have the director that's doing Nightwing. I mean, he's talking about the script is almost done and all this other shit. I mean, he's almost there, but you have the Titans TV show, which actually features a fucking Nightwing, and then you have a Nightwing movie.
Right.
And it's just really confusing. It's just really, really confusing how they're doing stuff right now, if they are doing this crap or not. Like you said, Gotham City Sirens, Suicide Squad 2, that kind of seems to be up the air. There's supposed to be that Harley Quinn Joker spinoff. There's the Joker origin. There's all these things that just keep getting thrown out there, and probably majority of them are just fake or they're just misunderstood. It's just ideas that some random crackhead in WB Studios just like, let's make a Harley Quinn Joker movie. All right, calm down there, Joe. You know, and right. It's like, and then the source gets out there like, WB's trying to make a Harley Quinn Joker movie.
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, that's how I could picture it. But at the end of the day, hopefully DC and Warner Brothers gets their shit together. I figured they're going to play it safe. After Justice League, I think they're going to play it safe. So making a Black Hawk movie, a fucking Birds of Prey movie.
That's not playing it safe.
That's not playing it safe. That's going really... I mean, like, if you can't fucking give us goddamn Zack Snyder's fucking vision for Justice League because you don't think it's going to be fucking mainstream enough, but you want to make a Black Hawk movie? What?
Went to the liquor store. I loaded up with alcohol. More specifically, vodka. Whiskey. Beer. Tequila. More beer. More vodka. More whiskey.
Exactly. Blackhawk down.
It just, I love the idea of the New Gods movie. Don't get me wrong, but New Gods as well? Like, what? Like, yeah. I love that, actually, that idea. But at the same time, that's about as little mainstream as possible. How the fuck are you going to get people to come see a movie called New Gods? I mean, there's no one that no one knows that's mainstream enough to present in that. No one knows what the fuck Orion is or Allfather or any of those Big Birda. No one knows who the fuck any of those are. Like, how do you put anybody in the foreground of that and say it's part of the DC universe?
Yeah.
You can't. So, what Green Lantern. DC universe? Make a fucking Green Lantern movie. Start off with that, huh? You got Shazam. You're starting good. You know, work it. Make a Dr. Fate movie, for God's sakes. Something that's at least a little bit fucking more reasonable. Just random shit here. Like we said, we're winging this, and I'm just spewing shit into the mic. We got one last thing here. If you have not checked it out on Vero, there is the BVS reference page, which, holy crap, man. There's people that just pump shit out on top of that thing. That thing just constantly is circulating a bunch of different stuff. But one thing I thought was kind of interesting, and I saw a couple articles on this, is they ran with one saying that Zack Snyder confirmed that in the nightmare scene, when Superman looks at Bruce as he's tied up, Batman as he's tied up, and he says, "You took her from me," and he puts his hand over his chest and, like, finger hand of death, whatever that is, secret hand of chopped death or some shit like that, and then he kills him, like, oh, that was a Joker reference from Injustice. Okay. Like, that... And they said in the article that Zack Snyder confirmed this. I looked. He just liked the post. That was it. He just fucking liked the post. I think that's kind of a stretch. I get what they're trying to say because he's blaming Batman for the death of Lois and Joker tricked Superman into killing Lois in the Injustice series. I get that's like there's a kind of correlation there.
Mm-hmm.
But they're trying to say the hand through the chest of the Joker is the same as this like little fucking Chinese wonton punch to the chest. I think sometimes we're stretching a little bit as BVS fans. Just a little bit.
Yeah. If you actually look at the BVS reference hashtag, there's quite a bit of stretching there. But, you know, it's cool. It's people having fun, you know, and enjoying it a little bit. But it does make me laugh when articles are published saying, oh, this is confirmed. Like, this is how we get our news now. Is people just pulling shit out of their ass, creating something out of nothing. And now we have a universe or whatever.
It's an obscure social media app with an obscure fucking page, and articles are pulling news from that.
Yep.
Fucking awesome.
Welcome to 2018.
What a day we live in where they have April Fool's articles that looked like they were fucking interesting at first, and then they... around on you.
Yeah.
Goddamn cutbags.
We have now come full circle with this whole episode. Boom! Blow your minds.
Anyway. So, hopefully this random fucking spewing of DC shit that happened over the past week or so is somehow interesting. Well, so, we're going to keep doing what we're doing and hopefully don't get tricked by April Fool's.
Yeah. No more of that shit. However... Everyone is still getting tricked by Mickey Mouse and Marvel.
Ooh, shots fired.
Bazinga.
The illusion of the mouse house. In case I don't see you.
Good afternoon, good evening, and good night.
Congratulations, you made it to the end of the video. You're one of very few to make it to the end.
Yes, thank you very much.
Make sure you hit that like button and subscribe to Comic Movie Marks Podcast and hit the notification bell. You know, all these fucking YouTube channels say this shit, so I'm going to say it now.
Yes, it's perfect. And if you want to hear our full podcast, you can check out our podcast on iTunes or any other podcast subscription service.
Make sure you subscribe. Thanks again.